Today on New Size World, an exclusive look into the life of a multi-Grammy-winning R&B superstar.
Hello, I'm Yusai Khan. Today I'm in Atlanta, Georgia, at the rehearsal studio of one of the most electrifying performers in the world. His name is simply Usher. But there is nothing simple about this young superstar. Join me as Usher takes us on a tour and talks about his rise to the top.
Watch this. These are my confessions. Just when I thought I said all I can say, my chick on the side says she got one on the way. These are my confessions.
At age 26, Usher is at the top of the record industry. His mega fame has earned him the titles global superstar, actor, businessman, and philanthropist. With over 13 million confessions albums sold on LaFace Zomba Records around the globe, Usher has risen to the top of the record charts as the world's number one R&B pop singer. His phenomenal level of success has soared far beyond earlier extraordinary achievements.
Who turned you on to music?
Who turned me on to music? I don't know. Music found me, you know. I, at a very young age, had a talent, obviously. My mother, she was the youth director of a group, choir. And man, somehow, some way, rather it was through gospel music, or rather it was just listening to the music on the radio, I created a love and a desire for it, you know. And the more I tried it, the more I got into, you know, developing my voice. You know, I realized that I wanted to be an artist, so I got into a group.
Confessions, Usher's fifth album, sold a record-breaking 1.1 million units in its first week out in March 2004, giving Usher his first simultaneous number one hits on the Billboard Top 200 Albums R&B Pop Charts, cashing in on multi-platinum record sales. In addition, Usher's platinum record sales earned four Grammys in 2005 and two People's Choice Awards, Best Male R&B Singer for the hit singles Yeah, featuring crunk rappers Lil Jon and Ludacris, tapping into the hip-hop culture, and My Boo, featuring a duet with Grammy winner Alicia Keys.
You gotta rock and wait in this.
The album Confessions allowed fans to feel up close and personal with relationship circumstances surrounding the pop star's personal life. The more intense the lyric content became, the higher the record sales. The popular hit My Boo with Alicia Keys expressed love for a special person fans could relate to.
What about Alicia Keys?
Yeah, I worked with her as well. Great, great artist, great vocalist. We actually won a Grammy together.
The songs that you have chosen to sing.
Yeah.
You write them?
Some of them.
What, do you have a favorite that you have written?
A favorite song that I have written?
Yeah.
No, I don't have a favorite. I kind of, all of my songs are kind of a testimony of my circumstance. And wherever I am and what I'm going through, I kind of find a way to tell a story. Or if there's someone around me, because at times I could be a product of my environment, I write about someone else's situation and kind of tell their story. Maybe because they don't have the voice to tell it. Mm-hmm. But I put myself in that situation and tell the story.
Well, rich, successful, famous, girls are flocking to you all the time, right? What do you look for in a woman?
What do I look for in a woman? A woman who does not react.
What does it mean?
I look to build strength in a relationship with a woman. And if she feels like I've done something to her in a relationship, and she goes and does something to me, obviously we're gonna, you know, there you have, okay, look, we can't put this back together. I look for a companion. I look for someone who is able to be supportive and be there for me, because I go through a lot.
The song titled Let It Burn allowed fans to feel closer to Usher, identifying with romantic relationships that lead to calling it quits. Romance, good or bad, seemed to be the sizzling theme behind Usher's multi-platinum steamy CD album, Confessions.
It ain't the same in your body, don't want you. But you know, gotta let it go, cause the party ain't jumping like it used to. No. Even though that's not true. Let it burn.
Did you ever expect to be so huge?
Well, I only hoped for the best. You know, I only hoped that people would receive my music and they would get some type of enjoyment, and it would be a means to have more success in other areas, like acting.
Mm-hmm. Who influenced you most? Who is that one person without her or him, you would never be where you are today?
I'd say Michael Jackson as a performer. Without being able to have him as a point of reference in terms of entertainment, I don't think this would have been as exciting. I probably would have continued to do it because I just enjoyed entertaining and I enjoyed singing.
Coming up next, Usher talks about the talent show that landed his big break in the record industry. Usher Raymond IV was born on October 14, 1978, and raised by his single mother and manager, Janetta Patton, in Chattanooga, Tennessee. At the age of six, he began singing and mesmerizing church audiences as a member of the St. Elmo Missionary Baptist Church Choir, directed by his mother. As choir director, Janetta Patton had the opportunity to hear Usher sing. Amazed by his charismatic singing and showmanship, Usher's mother realized her young son had the talent to become a great entertainer. Janetta Patton's intuition paid off. Usher's big break came at age 12, when Janetta decided to quit her job and manage his career. She later moved Usher and his younger brother James from Chattanooga, Tennessee to Atlanta, Georgia.
What was the big break?
The big break was a talent show in Atlanta, Georgia, where L.A. Reid, the former CEO of LaFace Records, he found me, his brother actually found me. And I was at a talent show in Atlanta. That was my big break.
Overwhelmingly impressed with the 13-year-old's performance, Brian Reid immediately arranged an audition with L.A. Reid, the co-president of LaFace Records. Legend has it, L.A. Reid offered Usher a contract on the spot. In 1994, at the age of 14 years old, Usher recorded and released his debut album on LaFace Records, entitled Think of You, produced by co-executive producer L.A. Reid and Sean P. Diddy Combs.
Coming up from, Chattanooga, Tennessee is a small town, and even Atlanta, you know, is not a big, big town. Why do you think your music has such wonderful universal appeal?
Well, Atlanta's big for many of things in music and creativity. They've always been very unique and been able to adapt from afar. In terms of the South, yeah, Atlanta's a big city for the South.
From somebody like myself, looking at your career, it seems like you have had such smooth sailing, you know? It's like from height to height. Any adversity?
Any adversity?
Yeah, tell me.
You have no idea.
Sure.
I couldn't tell you in a matter of minutes, you know, the adversity that I've been up against, but it kind of amazed. I was 15. I'd just been signed to my deal with LaFace Records, and I went through, or I experienced, vocal problems, a change. And I pretty much had a promise and future. I was a cute little kid who had, you know, just tons and tons and tons of confidence. I mean, I could walk into a room and just charm everybody and just make everybody feel comfortable. Because of the way I was raised, the way my mother and my grandparents raised me, I lost my voice. And all of the people who had come along for a 15-year-old and embracing, you know, oh, we're gonna be there for you and you're amazing and you're so great and everything, all those people turned their backs on me. and basically move to the next thing, which is what business is. Hey, you can't cut it, we gotta keep it moving, kid. And no matter how old you are, you know, hey, it is what it is. Get used to it, because you're gonna deal with that for the rest of your career.
After the moderate success of his first album, Think of You, and Puberty, the teen star met a cold record industry full of doubt that he would recover. But with faith and the support of a devoted managing mother and fans, Usher bounced back, reinventing himself in 1996 with the hit album My Way. Although the album won the hearts of record producers, the Fall from Grace experience set the standard for Janetta Patton on what it would take to keep her son in a competitive position in the record industry.
I have to say that if I had not been there with him, he would not be where he is today. Because at the age of 13, he went through puberty. He lost his voice. They didn't understand that. And the day that it actually happened, to see this little 14-year-old kid, you know, sit in a room and everyone just walk away from him like he's nothing, like he's absolutely nothing. It was horrible. And I just could not believe that people would be that bad.
In 1997, after graduating from high school, Usher released his sophomore album, My Way, displaying his maturity and songwriting abilities. He co-wrote 6 of 9 songs on the album with the help of producers Jermaine Dupri, Babyface, and Sean Puffy Combs. The album My Way put Usher back in the spotlight and at the top of R&B pop charts. As a result, he scored 3 single hits from his second album, You Make Me Wanna, Nice and Slow, and My Way. The records dominated the Billboard charts for over 10 weeks.
I'm in my drop top, cruising the streets.
Janetta, why did you call your son Usher?
I named Usher after his biological father. His name was Usher Raymond III, so Usher Raymond. Usher is Usher Raymond IV.
Uh-huh. But what does Usher really mean for you?
Joy.
Joy.
a bundle of joy.
In 1997, You Make Me Wanna, an R&B romantic classic, held the number 2 position on the pop singles chart, second to Elton John's popular Candle in the Wind. The success of My Way proved without a doubt that Usher had what it takes to be a superstar and regain the confidence of LaFace Records executive producers. Meanwhile, through the ups and downs of the young artist's career, his managing mom, Janetta Patton, never stopped believing in him.
What do you know about Usher that absolutely nobody else knows?
There's 5 personalities in there.
Tell me.
By 1998, Usher's phenomenal career moved him into the acting arena, appearing in the horror film The Faculty, and in 1999, a role in the urban high school drama Light It Up.
You see what you did? Do you? Do you?
I'm just doing my job.
Your job?
How could I have known that?
When did you ask? First day. First 10 minutes. You made up in your mind who we were.
Other TV credits include recurring appearances in 1996 on the syndicated TV show Moesha with starring pop artist Brandy. Usher appeared on several episodes as Jeremy Davis, a student romantically involved with the show's title character.
Mo, don't turn around. Now, I know I messed up your first surprise, so I got you another one. Oh, my God, Jeremy!
You're still looking good, Mo.
Thank you.
You know, we miss you over at Bridgewood.
Oh, so that's why nobody's called.
Yeah. In 1999, another hit album was released by LaFace Records, All About You, earning Usher the reputation as a sultry R&B singer. The pop star attributes his smooth sound to hard work and the vocal training of Grammy vocal coach Jan Smith. Coming up next, international vocal coach Jan Smith talks about what it's like to work with superstar Usher.
What is it like working with Usher?
In some ways, it's like working with anybody else, but he's not anybody else. In Usher's case, because of his climb to fame and with his celebrity becoming so great at this point in his career, he really had to raise the bar from his last record, 8701, to what we now hear as Confessions, which is the record that really has established him as a true vocalist.
Jan Smith and Usher's vocal training relationship has won many awards. The saga continues through the launching of his new record label, Us